Here we go. We're back.
Storm my show. Exercise stream. My voice is so tired. Talking so. I think today's exercise and fitness stream will be more focused on activity. I think that's a skill that I also need to improve. Building the value out of my pauses and silence. Went down too fast there. Like, that's like perfect. Balance. Maybe one more each side. It's like my audience enjoy silence. Just did slow squats, 5 each side. Loosen this, ready, down. Using the chair as like way of exercising. My arms. And I think that's good. Okay. I'm going to do my shoulder stretch. And you can join me from home, or hey, store this in your memory for times when you're bored or want some exercise. And hey, you can always drop chat, right, left, down. I think probably the biggest challenge for me with these exercise and fitness streams is checking the chat. Crossing my arms. Pull to one side. As I've said, I will be going to Alaska to see the Northern Lights later this week. So because of that, I may take a hiatus from streaming for the second half of this week. I might pick back up on Saturday. And I still view streaming to a great extent as like a hobby. It's like a way of like talking to people, passing time. I don't see it as like a viable career option for me at this point. I'm not gonna be able to like pull a MizKiff and make a living off of this, at least not at my numbers. Okay, those are washing machines. And then out, reach down, touch my toes, try to keep my legs straight. If I can't quite touch my toes, what I can do is just go down to like my ankles or knees. And then walk. And back. Let me change my angle a little bit. Touch and walk. I'll just go for 5. You can adjust your routines as much as you want. And I like leading these exercise streams because it's something I'm used to. Like, I'm used to exercising and demonstrating exercises. So it's easier for me to, kind of like the gaming streams I do, like talk and just chat. I don't need to worry as much about performing well or about trying hard, achieving a specific outcome. It's like I'm just better at those types of activities. And maybe it will get to be that way with art and piano at some point, where it's like I can just play piano on stream. And people can just pop into the stream, say, "Hey, yo, Stormer, what's up?" And like they can just say, "Hey, shoot the breeze," or whatever, recommend a song here or there. I can just be playing like piano. And who knows, we could have a music and an art stream tomorrow. Like Phoenix Wright, music, art, and reading, the big four. And it's, do my hip flexors. I do 5 each side typically. Just want to make sure I'm doing controlled movements. Whoa. Up, out, in, down. Balance is key. I think one more each side. And see, what was I gonna say? Yeah, flamingos, 15 seconds back, 15 seconds to the side. As I've been doing it, if you find yourself hopping around a lot, feel free to grab something to hold on to. This is all for the sake of stretching my leg muscles and promoting my sense of balance. And, it gets me counterbalancing myself there. And then forward. Yeah, I should say Phoenix music and reading aren't optional, because at this point in time, I don't have an idea for a project that I want to do. I've already showcased my art set, and some of my art skills in my previous Halloween art stream. If I did have an art stream, it would definitely be Halloween themed, but I'll say at this point optional, because I haven't yet settled on an idea. Music is a little bit easier for me because I have been working on these songs. Blade, then a more advanced version of Musette. I think I've gotten it to a reasonable enough speed to showcase it on stream. Sorrentina, which I can show what I've learned so far of the song. I don't yet think I'm ready to perform it on stream. And if not, I can just stop the music at 25 jumping jacks. One, 22, 23, 24, 25. Feeling good. I may have a fitness test coming up, so I want to keep maximizing my fitness. 10 stair jumps. Sometimes I get itchy because my skin is dry and no, it's like the dryness and the sweat don't jive sometimes. It just makes me itch. Yeah, and I don't know why that is, but yeah. Let's see, I'll do burpees, I think I can showcase some of the bicep drills too. I'm waiting to recover from the burpees, I'll do 10, mountain climbers, slow push-ups, slow sit-ups, abdominal set. Oh, before we forget, I almost always forget these. Thigh stretches, just have to be careful of the fan. 2, 3, let gravity do the work. 4, 5, pretty good. Yeah, you can see I'm like, skin, dang it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Catch my breath while I'm doing that. Soap is a good one too. Rise, drop. Soap, dog food, water. And I just keep lifting, slow drop. Really, you can do it both sides. Just let your arm do the work. There we go. Rise, drop. Then when this arm gets tired, I switch. Rise, drop. Like so. probably do like 20 of these each arm, this amount of weight. Then weave through. Make sure you got good enough weight. Be careful, y'all. You don't need any catastrophes. Just do it over and over until my muscles burn. Good. Switch sides. Down. Lift. Maybe there's not a crack in the lid. I'm not looking for a mess. Clean. There. I think that's pretty much good with the Purex. Okay. There are all kinds of stretches you could do. I think you could do these too. I forgot. Okay. We're getting close to the finish line. Six, two, one, resting. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 second set. Here we go. Resting. Okay, third set. Here I go. Resting. So I think this is the fourth one. You can see my leg muscles getting tired. Slow push-ups. Back. Why not? Let's try diamond again.
I'll just go for 5. Okay. Not bad. Little sit-ups, when in reality I'm dropping. This is number 5. Good. Leg set. Pretty good. Hold. Lift. Rest. Okay, up and out. There we go. Let your body be your guide. Final set. Okay. Pretty good. I think that will conclude my exercise set today. They do keep leaving out running and walking in place. I have to remember that. There's really not much to it. Okay, let's wrap up with mindfulness. I did already walk a mile today about, so that kind of helps neutralize. Okay. Sweating up a storm. Okay. Let's see. We have tried a lot of these already. Sweat just keeps running down. All right, let's try this. We've already done a 3-minute breathing space. So let's try mindful walking down the street. I do walk down the street a lot, so if you're like me and you like to go on walks, this could help you. In addition to the Calm app, which I personally use. Stuff out of my eyes. One core process that can be influenced by mindfulness practice is our ability to observe our thoughts, emotions, and sensations without reacting to fix them, hide them, or solve them. You can hear my stomach grumbling there. This awareness creates room for choice between impulses. An action which can help develop coping skills and positive behavioral change. In in the first step, you see a scenario, a time when you're walking down a familiar street, and you look up and you see someone you know on the other side. They wave. However, up the perspective here. You're walking down the street. Hey Twitch, thanks for watching. Thank you for chatting, and you can help the channel if you follow. As a reminder, it's one way of showing support if you don't have the ability to donate. Whew, man, hot. And the best part about falls is they're free. Okay, 10 push-ups, okay, deal. Let me get through this mindfulness first, though, okay? Okay, so you're walking down the street. You wave, but the other person doesn't wave back. They continue walking past. Next, think about the situation as you were imagining. Did you notice any thoughts that you have? Me personally, if I imagine myself in this situation and I'm walking down the street and someone at the other side, someone I know, and I wave at them and they don't respond and just walk by, I would feel probably frustrated and maybe sad, upset that I wasn't acknowledged. Because when I'm walking around, even people I don't know tend to wave back when I wave at them. And as you were imagining, did you notice any emotions? So yeah. Finally, think about your emotions and thoughts that came up during this exercise. How these emotions and thoughts in turn influence your behavior, whether you found this helpful, and if you have any final comments. I think it is kind of just responding to the mindfulness activity. I think that it is a good practice, because it can help you become more in tune with how people respond to you, especially if they respond in ways that aren't maybe what you'd expect. It helps you be more somewhat socially friendly and better able to adapt to some types of social interactions. Okay, Twitch. 10 push-ups, huh? Okay. I think we're about to hit our 50 follower mark too, so that'd be pretty cool if you could. Okay. Hold on. I just did 5 slow ones, so 10 push-ups should be a piece of cake. Okay. Second. So here I am, flat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Whoa, where'd you go? Huh. 12. Full range of motion. Not sure what you mean. Do you have an explanation? Because I was going all the way down. You can see my nose touching the floor. I'm coming back to a full plank. So unless there's another way of doing a push-up I'm not sure of, I believe you owe me a follow. Lock out your elbows. Do you have full range of motion push-ups? Okay, hold on a second. Put your back into it. Okay. Let's sell this once and for all. Okay. Okay. Okay, so this is Mind Pump TV. Let me see if I can turn on the sound.
Myself to squeeze the shoulder blades. That's all this really is to remind myself to peel those shoulder blades back and then press up with the chest. Now the other mistake that clients make a lot is from this position down low is they don't keep a rigid back and they do this and they push up with their low back and their low back arching. So when you're down in this position, I squeeze the back, I tighten my abs, and then I push through the floor. From all the way down, tighten my abs, squeeze my back, press through the floor. Come all the way down, squeeze my back, press through the floor. Keeping those abs tight the entire time so that we don't have this major excessive arch in the low back. Now, everyone's gonna be a little bit different as far as how wide you go. And that's why I like to do the side test, come in front and then retract, because it should bring you right back to about a 90 degree bend. Now that doesn't mean if you bring your arms a little bit in, does it make it wrong? But if you bring it in, the more you start to bring your hands in, the more triceps are involved. The further you flare out, as you start to flare up, the more shoulders involved. So you want to put your hands in a nice, comfortable position that the chest is the primary mover, but that doesn't mean that you can't play with the hand placement to work different parts of your upper body. So a push-up actually can be really challenging. You have to support your entire body weight. You have to keep your abs tight. You have to know how to keep the shoulders retracted. So a lot of times clients have a really hard time doing this and then feeling it in the right area. So I don't care how strong you think you are, or even if you can press out 10 or 15 push-ups, if you're not doing them properly, you're not feeling them where you're supposed to, I highly recommend that you do a regression to the movement first and then work up with having good mechanics before you start to do a full push-up. One way to do that is actually to go from your knees. So your starting position is just like we talked about before, sit up tall and straight, the hands come in front, retract to get yourself in that hand position, but you're going to go from your knees. So I have my hands in that position. I still start all the way from the floor. I bring the feet up off the ground, retract, squeeze the back, and then make sure the abs are tight, press through the floor, come all the way down, squeeze the back again, abs tight, press through the floor, come all the way down, squeeze the back, abs tight, press through the floor. Listen, if you guys liked that video, it helped you out, make it up off the floor. And this is getting my back engaged because I want the shoulder blades squeezed. And then I press up through the floor, come all the way back down, leave your hands off the floor again, reminding myself to squeeze the shoulder blades. That's all this really is to remind myself to peel those shoulder blades back and then press up with the chest. Now, the other mistake that clients make a lot is from the shoulder down low, is they don't keep a rigid back.
Okay. Mind Pump TV. Okay, Mind Pump. Seems like he knows what he's doing. Okay. Alright, thank you for the follow, Twitch. Hope you all enjoyed my exercise regimen. Feel free to check out my other fitness videos on YouTube, Stormer Show. Thank you for watching, and hope you all have a good night.